I kind of got to where I decided I didn't really need 50 pounds of whole cane sugar or 50 pounds of pinto beans. You know, I just didn't have to have them in buckets in the basement. I did go through that phase for a while, kind of over that. For more advice and encouragement on starting a homestead of your own, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified when we post a new video every Tuesday. If you live in a rural area like I do, or even just a place with not a lot of quality grocery store options, by the end of this video, you'll have ideas and tools for finding organic or whole food groceries no matter where you live. We've been eating a mostly organic diet for about 8 years now, and these are my proven tricks for finding groceries in a place where there just isn't much to choose from. So as many of you know, we live in Wyoming. It has wide open spaces, lots of room to breathe, and not a single Whole Foods market in the entire state. As much as I love living here, we just don't have the local or organic food sources or stores like many folks in other regions do. We're really behind the times in a lot of aspects, which is sometimes good, but sometimes can make it feel a little bit like a food desert. However, we still eat a really good, primarily whole foods, organic diet, and I've managed to figure out how to do that without breaking the bank or spending my life driving 6 hours to the various health food stores down in Colorado. Because let's be honest, ain't nobody got time for that. So the first strategy I use when I'm stocking our pantry or freezers is to grow as much as possible, which that probably doesn't come as a surprise considering we homestead and this is a homesteading channel, but our fruit production really, really takes the edge off of our grocery bill and has grown and shifted over the years. But as of right now, we grow a lot of our own food. We grow all of our own beef, which is about one steer every 12 to 18 months, most of our pork, which is about 1 to 2 hogs every other year or so. All of our own chicken. We do a batch of 30 meat birds 1 to 2 times per year, depending on how much room I have in the freezer. And a lot of our own dairy, which does vary a bit depending on the cow's lactation cycle or how much cream she's giving, etc. We do almost all of our own eggs, although the chickens sometimes go into seasonal periods where they don't give us any eggs. And of course, we do vegetables, potatoes, garlic, and onions in our garden, but that only gives us enough for about 6 to 8 months out of the year, or maybe a little bit less. It just depends on the growing season and how much we were able to plant. So I know growing a ton of food at home isn't in the cards for everyone, although I do think that everyone can grow at least a little something, even if it is a herb garden in the windowsill. But if you can't grow your own meat or eggs or dairy, just be sure to seek out local producers or farmers for those items. I know for me personally, I love being able to support local growers whenever I'm a little short on pork in the freezer or things like that. And I don't mind paying a little bit more for products that I know have been grown sustainably or grown ethically or grown locally with better practices and standards. So we do buy a few things locally at our local stores, even though we don't have a lot of options. We do have one tiny natural food store in the larger town that is south of us, and that's where I will get sometimes low temperature vat pasteurized milk if the cow's dry, sometimes eggs to supplement the hens if they're not laying, or the occasional organic pantry item. And I also do get some things at just the regular old grocery store. I don't want to give the impression that we never do that, because we do. We follow the 80-20 rule, which means we don't eat a perfect diet, and sometimes I do buy tortillas or sometimes sandwich bread or chips just to preserve my sanity. I know how to make those things myself, I like making them myself, but it's not always in the schedule for that given week, and I'm okay with supplementing here or there. We also sometimes pick up things like bananas or avocados at the local store just because that's not something I'm able to order in, and we're definitely not going to grow those ourselves here in Wyoming. We do have a farmer's market that runs in our area from about August to October. It's not quite as robust as some farmers markets that you might have in other areas, and I do go there to supplement different vegetables or meats, etc., during that period of the year. it's not always easy for me to spend an entire Saturday driving to town and going to the market and coming back. So honestly, it's not something I'm able to utilize as much as I'd like, but hopefully you have a more available or more accessible farmers market in your area and you can really take advantage of that in your grocery shopping. Another store I add into our routine is Costco. Now the closest one is about an hour and a half away, so I don't go there all the time, maybe every month or so, but we got a membership finally last year and I'm using them more than I ever thought. I love Costco for getting things like quality cheeses or organic lunch meats to have when we have crews of people working here, the organic pasta, sometimes I grab some coconut oil or raw honey. They do have some really good organic and natural options if you know where to look. I don't get any meats or anything there, but it's great if we're stocking up for a crowd and things like toilet paper, paper towels, diapers, and so on. Okay, so pause the video for just a sec and comment below to tell me your favorite thing to buy from Costco if you have a membership, because I'm curious about any hidden gems that I might be missing, because I know they're there. So you can see that my grocery strategy really involves picking and choosing different items from a variety of places, which isn't as complicated as it sounds, and your stores and your routine will look a little different than mine. But this last option is one that's really filled in a huge gap for me, and it is something that's going to be available to you no matter where you live. And this option is called Thrive Market, and they're not sponsoring this video. I'm just telling you about them because I really do use them every single month. But they're kind of like a cross between Amazon and Whole Foods, and they're all online. And so you do get a membership just like Costco, and then you order whatever you want from month to month. They usually have free shipping for orders over $50, so I like to save up my orders until I'm over that $50 threshold. And then I buy a lot of my organic pantry staples or dry goods or greens, nuts, things like that. Okay, I just wanted to show you here on the Thrive Market website, this is what one of my recent orders look like, and it really varies from month to month. And I don't order every single month. Sometimes I skip. There's nothing that says you have to order every month, but that's the interval that works the best for me. But I do a lot of herbs and spices just to refill my little jars in the kitchen. I do like the Thrive Market label for a lot of the products. It's a little bit cheaper and the quality is still really good. I got some Redmond Real Salt, maple syrup, sucanat, which is my granulated sugar of choice. I use that instead of a lot of white sugar or regular brown sugar. Popcorn, some more spices. Do dried beans here, oats, nuts, things like that. And it's really easy. Shipping was free because this order was over $50. Sometimes they give you a free gift with the order. So it's just a really good option for me since I don't have a lot of organic options locally. Maybe you would find all this similar pricing at Whole Foods. I don't know. But this just seems like a really, really good option for us rural folks. If you would like to check out Thrive Market and potentially add it into your grocery shopping routine, I'll drop a link to them in the show notes below. The last option that I've used kind of intermittently over the years is Azure Standard. Now you may not have this in your area if you live back east. For those of you who are Midwest and over, this is a whole food kind of bulk buying co-op. Now you do have to get with a group of other people in your area because you have to have a certain amount for the truck to stop and drop the food in your town. But I have used this on occasion to get things in bulk. Sometimes they have good deals on big boxes of apples or big boxes of peaches. Because of the way they ship the food in on a semi-truck, you have to coordinate drop times, which is a little tricky when you live as far out of town as we do. And I kind of got to where I decided I didn't really need 50 pounds of whole cane sugar or 50 pounds of pinto beans. You know, I just didn't have to have them in buckets in the basement. I did go through that phase for a while, kind of over that. But if you have Azure Standard in your area or you have friends that you could potentially get with and place a big order, that could be an option, especially if you need a lot of bulk. So there you have it, guys. That's exactly how I piece our grocery list together to make it work in our rather bland area. I firmly believe you don't have to live in a mecca of organic foods or stores to have a more whole foods lifestyle that's much healthier for you. Now, if you're wanting more of the nitty-gritty on how we grow our own vegetables or raise chickens or even have our dairy animals, I have a special library of homestead resources I created just for my loyal readers and subscribers. And I'm making it available for free to you today. just go to theprairiehomestead.com/grow, G-R-O-W, or click the link below to grab it. If you like this video, I'd love for you to let me know by giving it a thumbs up and sharing it with your fellow homesteaders. And then be sure to drop a comment below and tell me what type of grocery options you have in your area. I'm really curious to know if most of you have lots of things to choose from or a little bit more limited like me. And that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.